Yes, we came in with my family, my parents, and my brothers and sisters in 1969. And we started working on the fields. We were traveling in all different states, following crops. And we were always like kind of scared going to the devil's gardens, you know, because it was famous for rattlesnakes. Mm. They were paying the bucket 25 cents and you can hardly see, find the peppers, trying to tell, you know, the crew leader that, no, we scared now with the snakes, you know. Mm-hmm. So everybody was, we were so scared. I was so scared. This lawyer that was, you know, there too. So they went with them to the fields. The farmer was there and a lot of the, they were wearing like jackets of the military and with guns. And after that, we have a big strike. That was a big, big strike in Immokalee because of that, you know, what happened to us in El Jardín del Diablo. The next day, it was a big freeze. Mm-hmm. And it was, everything was like, you know, burn everything. It was bad. That freeze was really bad. Right. It was Cesar Chavez. He stood here in my house for one night and he took off to Homestead early, but we were here almost all night long talking and eating. I was cooking like always, making enchiladas. Anyway, we kept working here for the season, and then moving with my family up north. You know, different places. The condition of the houses where you're. Where we were living, they are in very bad conditions, you know. One time I was very close because the guy that was putting the pesticides, I wasn't paying attention because I was speaking so fast. So I went to the wrong side. So all the pesticides, the air, you know, blow in my face, my body. And then after that, I was so sick that they had to bring me to the clinic. My husband died very young. He was 45.
45,
he was 3 years with leukemia. He was sick, thank you to Sister Mary Heisen, Sister Mary Lang, the sister, you know, Maureen.
Yeah.
They were helping us. It was amazing. It was kind of, my husband was always saying that God, you know, is always, you know, taking care of you, no matter what we go through, you know. And one other thing about Sister Maureen, so they went to the fields and this crew leader, he was treating them really bad and he didn't let them drink water. So he was really mean, and then he ended up saying, you know, you can go walk to Immokalee, you know. So they did walk from the fields to Immokalee, my brother and my mother. So they stopped at the legal services. So they found Sister Maureen there. So she took them and she went so brave to see. She said, they have to pay you. And my brother was always talking to everybody that she was the best lawyer of the world. I have another testimony about Sister. This is nothing to do with
law,
cases of law. But I was feeling so sick after my husband died. I told her that they were going to do some tests because they told me that it might be cancer or something, you know, and I was so, you know, down. And then I remember Sister Maureen, very brave. I've been getting that from her. She said, okay, you're a lady, a woman of faith, she said. You don't worry about it because you're a woman of faith. And then I say, oh my goodness, those are impacts that I never forgot about that, you know.